What is up, everybody? It is Master Rov here with the update video for Clash of Clans. Now, all of the sneak peeks have been released. I know lots of people have been doing each sneak peek each day in a video, but I thought I'd wait until they're all out, and then we can run through them together and have a look at them all. So this is, you can see here, a video of the forum. This is where, obviously, all the stuff was announced. So let's scroll down and see what they are. So, the first sneak peek is the Tesla level 8. So this can now get up to level 8. I think mine are only level 1, level 2 now, something like that. But yeah, they are now going up to level 8, which basically means they are going to be unbelievably powerful. So this is obviously to stop things like Pekkas and stuff. It's going to be insane. People's bases are probably soon going to be pretty much centered around a hidden Tesla kind of base. I'm looking forward to see what bases come out that are very much hidden Tesla centered. Which will be quite interesting. So that's a cool little update. So basically we're getting another level of the hidden Tesla. Now, number two was one that personally I thought was quite cool. I've only been given the Valkyries a few times, but when I've used them, they seem kind of pointless almost. But now the Valkyries are going to be good. It says here, she's felt underachieved, so we gave her some more training and a new skill was born. Reintroducing the Valkyrie, the Wild Whirlwind. With her mighty axe, she will now attack multiple targets that are placed close to each other. So that is what is going to be going on with the new Valkyrie update. She looks pretty menacing in this. Look, she looks like she's gone through some rough training. But yeah, the Valkyrie now has got a new tactic. She can do a whirlwind, and she can destroy lots of buildings around her, which is going to make her very useful, especially for those tightly packed bases. All right, sneak peek number 3 is the new jump spell level 3. So, regardless of the level, the spell will now affect all troops deployed, even those outside of its radius. So it's basically, you're just putting it into the battlefield. It's not like the rage spell where you're putting it in, and if you step inside it, you'll get rage. This is, if you use this, everybody can use it. So that's pretty cool. And then it also causes troops to direct themselves immediately if it opens to a more advantageous route. So it will change its decision and go, actually, now I can jump and all this, I will go this way because I can get more damage, which is really, really good. And, you know, they'll work a lot better, I guess. So as you can see here, it works better to break through walls and everything. It's just going to be insane. That is something I'm looking forward to using. So sneak peek number 4 is, of course, the Pekka level 5. So it improves its battle prowess, and those swords have never been sharper. So this is obviously the upgraded Pekka, looking like a tank like he always has to. So he's just going to be bigger, meaner, and pretty insane. And also a little side note here is Hog Riders do take more damage now to giant bombs, which means if you're trying to set up your anti-hog base, the giant bombs are going to make an even bigger difference, which is pretty nice. And then sneak peek number 5, which personally was my favorite at the moment, we can now live view our friend's clan. So we can slag them off or cheer them on and watch it live to see how they're doing in Clan Wars, which is pretty cool, and I'm looking forward to that. And also, as you can see, the other little A here, the little note, you can now have clan mail twice as long. So those messages don't need to be abbreviated. You can now go into further detail on attacks, on donations, who's about to get kicked, and who is doing well or bad. So that is really good. You know, sending out clan mail and having a really limited amount of characters. I mean, we're not trying to tweet at them or anything. We want to send them a message. And you can't send your troops a message with, like, I don't know. It's like, I don't even think it's like 100 characters. It's like 75. I don't know. It's a small amount of characters. And then the last, but probably one of the best sneak peeks, is the readjusted strength, smarter defending, and stronger abilities of the heroes. That is right. So they are now a little bit better in all wear. I'll run through the what they do down here, because this is probably the most important bit. So heroes can no longer be lured out. So that's going to be a load of tactics gone out the window now. They'll only attack people that come into their area. So it's very much like any other defensive building. Hit points and damage for the queen and hit points for the king have been slightly increased at lower levels. So they're going to be slightly more powerful at the lower levels than they were before, which is good because they were powerful, but they're not, you know, they're nothing too amazing. But now they're going to have a little bit of extra power. However, hero hit points and damage have been decreased at higher levels for better balance. So it's basically going to make a tighter gameplay. Leveling each one up is not going to make it as damaging, as they're already going to start off pretty powerful. That's going to be quite interesting. And hero abilities now improve much more significantly with each new ability level. So the best way to make your hero stronger is increase their ability level. So that's quite cool. So all the rage and whatever will be a lot stronger now, and will do more damage. So here we go, the Barbarian King. His damage has been reduced, but he can now heal himself greatly when using the Iron Fist ability. That's cool. The Barbarian Horde summoned by Iron Fist has doubled in size to cause more mayhem. Use the Iron Fist at the right time to help the king take more damage than he could before. So he's basically, they're basically putting more emphasis on the abilities rather than the actual characters or heroes themselves. And the Archer Queen, her hit points have been reduced in later levels, but the Queen now gains a tremendous damage boost while her Royal Cloak ability is active. The duration of the Royal Cloak has been greatly increased in lower levels. Again, it's all about balancing. It's all about making that a really tight leveling system between the lowest levels and the highest levels. Use Royal Cloak at the right time to help the Queen hit more important targets harder than she ever has before. Again, more damage. So there you go, guys. There are the six different sneak peeks coming in the next update. Hopefully the next update is coming Wednesday. That is when it is rumored to drop. But obviously, we're not 100% sure on that. So I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. For everything Clash of Clans and Boom Beach, come back to me. It's been awesome having you here. Until the next video, guys. Peace out.